The time has come that the Iraqi people must solve their own problems. This is according to U.S. President Barack Obama regarding the current situation of Takfiri terrorists of the Islamic State of Iraq and the Levant and controlling the second largest city in Iraq and are threatening other regions. What Obama fails to say is that if the United States had never invaded and occupied Iraq, and if Washington had not supported terrorists against the Syrian government for what it thought was its own interest, then the Iraqis would not be facing what they are currently, and the region and the world would not be threatened by these bloodthirsty monsters that don't care about humanity whatsoever. Whether Shia, Sunni, Christian, or secular, in Iraq, just as in Syria, everyone is a possible target, and this goes for the rest of the world also. And what we're seeing in Iraq is not a Shia-Sunni conflict. This is between Haq and Batil, right and wrong. Mr. Obama, it is as if you're in a forest. You gather the wood, you add the lighting fluid, you light it and fan it, and then you walk away and you say, if the forest burns, it is somebody else's problem. The United States, Saudi Arabia, Turkey, Qatar, United Kingdom, France have all supported these terrorists financially, have given them the latest weapons and all kinds of equipment, have encouraged them in every way possible to overthrow the Syrian government. And now are you surprised that after the terrorists are losing in Syria, that they have crossed over the border to wreak havoc in Iraq? They have been committing terrorist acts for years now, even in Iraq, but never with such boldness as we are witnessing today. After the success of the Iraqi presidential election, terrorists have become even more desperate as their plan to cause instability in the region would be set back by any semblance of stability and normalcy in Iraq. But perhaps you are right, Mr. Obama. This time the Iraqis will solve the problem themselves, and inshallah, their strength will become obvious. In one day, when Ayatollah Sistani issued the Edict of Jihad, 1.5 million Iraqis signed up to fight the terrorists. This is the power of true Islam, and if the Iraqis, along with other Muslims, realize their potential, no terrorist group nor their supporters would be able to humiliate, control, or kill Muslims or the oppressed in mass again. The Islamic State of Iraq and the Levant, along with those supporting them, are about to be introduced to real Islam. May Allah curse and eliminate the oppressors, and may He guide and help the defenders of truth. Relations between Russia and the United States are at an all-time low. Now, this follows a 2009 so-called resetting of the button regarding relations between the two countries. Moscow-Washington relations had deteriorated in 2008, dealing with the Russian-Georgian war, the different sides of the spectrum that Washington and Moscow were on. Well, we saw U.S. missile systems set up in Eastern Europe, and then the situation in Libya took place when we saw the overthrow of Muammar Gaddafi and Western countries' involvement there. Following that, there was Syria, where Russia stood firm in not allowing another invasion of another Muslim country by the West in the name of human rights to take place. Then we saw the Edward Snowden incident, where the U.S. whistleblower has taken refuge in Russia, and it appears the final blow has been Ukraine. We've been witnessing months of demonstrations spearheaded by the West in Ukraine. We've seen many Western politicians addressing demonstrators or meeting with opposition members. We saw demonstrators being very aggressive and attacking police. Then we saw the Ukrainian government, President Viktor Yanukovych, signing an agreement with the opposition where they agreed to power sharing and early elections. However, that was not the direction that those who were manipulating the situation wanted it to go. Thus, we see a coup in Ukraine taking place right after that, trying to replace the government with those who totally want the West to be involved and control the country. And now we see a firm reaction by the Vladimir Putin government of Russia, as Russian troops have been sent into the Crimea region. Washington and Western capitals are threatening the Russians, with U.S. Secretary of State John Kerry repeating a familiar slogan, all options are on the table. And Kerry said, you don't invade a country on phony pretexts. This is quite interesting coming from a country like the United States, which has fought war after war based on phony pretexts. This time, though, it appears that Washington has gone too far, and the bear has drawn the line and is growling, not this time, not in my backyard. Keep your eyes on Ukraine to see what lies next for the bear and the stars and stripes. The battle continues. Boko Haram, the terrorist group in Nigeria, has gained more attention after being responsible for the kidnapping of over 250 schoolgirls. Many questions come up when looking at Boko Haram. How does a group of ragtag half-literate individuals suddenly gain the ability to carry out sophisticated coordinated attacks in various points of the country? The reality is that the most populated country on the African continent has been targeted, like most of the other countries on that continent, by imperialist powers. In the case of Nigeria, it is the United States which is behind attempting to limit the power of the most populous country on the continent. With a population of 174 million people, the possibilities for Nigeria are unlimited. A country filled with natural resources, from oil and natural gas to precious gems and stones, makes it ripe for targeting for those who want to exploit it. In order to keep a country from controlling its own destiny and resources, division amongst the people is necessary. Instilling fear in the people and causing instability are also good modus operandi in order to allow foreign powers' troops inside of the country to help return normalcy or security to the land, allegedly. Thus, this gives this power a more direct foothold on the soil without raising more suspicion. Where there is oil, there are usually American boots on the ground. A good sign to get the pulse of what's going on in the international political stage is the way American politicians react to any event. We have the likes of U.S. President Barack Obama, Senator John McCain, and former Secretary of State Hillary Clinton, who are directly responsible for the deaths of girls, boys, men, and women from Iraq, Afghanistan to Africa, crying out for the kidnapping of over 250 black girls in Nigeria. Oh, please. They represent a country that is responsible for the killing of millions of black, white, and brown people around the world. So why the sudden compassion for these girls? It is not a matter of the black girls, but the black gold and other natural resources in Nigeria. They want to control, and they must do it through destabilization. This is the reason that a group like Boko Haram or Al-Qaeda serves the interests of hegemony. It paints an evil face of Islam and opens the way for the colonial saviors to come in and supposedly save the natives. This is the reason you have seen that Boko Haram released a video having the so-called clown of a leader, Abu Bakr Shekau, threatening to sell the girls on the black market. This way, if just the news about the girls being kidnapped wouldn't get enough attention, then having a video go viral and showing him smirking and talking about selling the girls would get a reaction globally. Then, of course, as the masses show their outrage, then the saviors from London, Paris, or in this case, Washington, can go in and try to find and save the girls. Wake up. When has any of these colonialistic, hegemonistic powers been interested in fighting for the masses on the ground? And how can an entity that is responsible for killing on a daily basis, whether it is in Afghanistan, Somalia, Iraq, or Yemen, really care about human life? How can a country that supports the Israeli entity that has basically imprisoned the Palestinian population and cut off 1.7 million Gazans from the world, depriving them of their basic necessities, care about others? How can a country that turns its back on the creation of a segregation wall in Palestine and the stealing of the land of the natives and the killing of many care about Nigerian girls? This is not about Nigerian girls. Again, it is about Nigerian resources. This is not about Boko Haram terrorism, but American terrorism done in the name of Islam. Wake up, everyone. Boko Haram, made and funded in the USA.